Assalamu alaikum. If you remember yesterday, we had a look at the chapters in which we went to the voyage, and that was coming back, actually went coming back from the land of the giants, and he was rescued by a ship. And today we are going on a new voyage. Now, the two voyages that we had before, Bade Mazeke The, one was the land of the when he was a giant, and the other one was when he was a dwarf, and rather not just a dwarf, he was a tiny little man, and they were giants over there. Now, today we are going to visit a land which is very strange, very interesting, very strange as well. और ये जो तीसरा पार्ट है इसके 11 चैप्टर्स हैं एंड वी आर गोना हैव अ लुक एट द फर्स्ट 5 टुडे एंड इन द फर्स्ट फ्यू चैप्टर्स वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अ लॉट अबाउट द आइलैंड्स सो द आइलैंड दैट वी आर गोइंग टू विजिट इज दिस इज द थर्ड वॉयज व्हिच इज वॉयज टू लापूटा वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अ लॉट अबाउट लापूटा टुडे एंड देन ही इज आल्सो गोइंग टू गो टू बांदी बारबी व्हिच इज अनदर आइलैंड व्हिच इज अंडरनीथ लापूटा. But we are going to have a look at that in minor details. But today the main portion that we're going to visit is Laputa. So when he goes on, the chapter starts off by, he stayed home with his family for 10 days. And then there was a captain, William Robinson, and his ship was called Hopewell. Ship ka naam tha. He wanted him to be a surgeon on that ship, so he comes along, he takes him, employs him as a surgeon, and he was about to set off on a voyage towards the East Indies. East Indies ki taraf jo hai wo nikle hai, and they wanted to go towards that side of the world. And the ship sailed in 1706. When it arrived in 1707, actually in August 1706, and after a few months, it was like April 1707, and it Fort St. George, they reached there and they landed there, and they were stayed there for 3 weeks, and uske baad jo hai the crew members fell ill, they became very very sick. And then the ship sailed to another part where the captain decided to stay for a little while again, and he decided to send Gulliver on a little boat to go off in search of some other places. Now, this was actually it was taken aur usko captain bana diya ke tum jao and then you discover different places. Now then, as he was in that boat, it was taken over by a storm, and it was also chased by some pirates. Us waqt pirates bahut hote the. They were the people who used to loot the ships and kill these people and take away everything that they had. And they actually took everything away from him, but he begged and begged them. And he wanted to get away, so they he was put on a little boat, normal people put on a little boat, and he was sent off to another place where he was it touched an island, and his boat was going in the sea, and it then touched an island. The island was actually very rocky, there were lots of rocks on it, and he was not feeling very good. He was feeling a bit alone, and he wasn't very happy about it, and he thought he was gonna die there, ki main wahin pe bechara mar khap jayega. Lekin do din ke baad, a couple of days later, he perceived a big hanging thing at the top, like a big hanging bit over there at the top, which is there, and on that big thing, like a big massive you can say rock, he saw little people walking on the island as well. And he saw human beings, actually insaan jo hai uske upar chal rahe the, and he sort of they spotted him as well, aur unhone wahan se apni imagine kare upar ek jagah hai, and they threw down their rope unhone niche phenki, and it was actually a chain, not a rope, it was a chain which came down, and on that end of the chain there was a little seat to sit on, and they pulled him up on the island, and he found himself There were a lot and lot of people around him, and he could not understand their language. But he was surprised to see these different looking people. They were his size, but they were very different looking people, and he could not understand what was going on. So it was it's kind of like a scientific wonder. He is saying that things which are far away, jo hame hamari samajh se bahar hai cheeze, ya hame nahi pata chalti, we wander off to them, and when we see them closely, we are not very keen on these things which are new to us and alien to us. So that is the kind of something, a lesson that he wanted to portray to us. And that puts an end to the chapter first, chapter one of this part three, and we move on to the next chapter, which is in which he describes these people, of what the people of this land look like, the people of Laputa look like. Now, on this island, he felt wondered because these were had different shapes and faces. Now, saying exactly what he saw, their hands were all reclined either to the right or to the left. One of their eyes turned inwards, which was inside, and one of the other ones was directly up to the zenith. So it was like one looking up and one looking this way. So it was like a very strange, and then arms on either this side or this side. So they were strange looking creatures. Now, the other thing that they had is that these people had servants. They were followed by servants, and what the servants used to do is they had flappers, like samajh le bade bade pankhe nahi hote, they had those round things and the flappers. Now the purpose of these flappers was ke ye jo log the, they forgot that they needed to speak when they needed to speak, and they forgot when they needed to listen. So when it was time for them to listen, the servant flapped their ears and they had to listen. And when they had to see something or look at something, they flapped their eyes and they had to, or their mouth to speak. So it was like flapping their mouths kya bole, or flapping their ears to listen now. And it was a strange thing again. So it was very different from the way normal people are. Then again, like all the other two lands, this island also had a king. And when he was taken to the king, it took 1 hour to the king. Gulliver had to stand there or sit there, God knows what, waiting for the king to respond to him, because he could not understand what was going on. It took him 1 hour for the king to understand ki yahan pe ho kya raha hai. Then after that, his language was very different as well, so there was a lot of difficulty in understanding what was going on. Then the meal was served, khana served kiya gaya. Now when the food was served, they were all different shapes. The mutton meat was cut into triangular shapes. The beef was also cut into some rhomboid shapes, and the pudding was the shape of a cycloid, very interesting way it was done. And he also found that there were shapes, the puddings were also given the shapes, meetha jo tha unka, they were desserts, they were in the shape of guitars, flute, fiddle, harp, and the bread was also cut into cone shaped. It was like ye bread ki shape hai, this is the shape of a bread. Now this is very interesting, how can they cut it like this, but they were interestingly, this is how they like the figures, the cyclone, the cylinders, the parallelograms, all the foods were done this way. Now the name of this island was Laputa, and it meant, he picked up that name as he went along after a few days, and he came to understand that it meant the flying island. Now on this island, there were the tailor was called to make him an outfit for Gulliver, and he measured him from all sides, idhar se bhi measure kiya, or dimensionally he was measured all around rather than this way and that way, he was measured like a circumference and all around, like a mathematical figure or like a mathematical way to do it. But and when it was done, it did not fit him properly, because obviously the tailor came to say ki maine galat calculations jo hai wo kar di hain, and it's not really something that fitted him properly. Now the music, one of their favorite things. The king, they played many musical instruments, and the people, and they learned that they had their good ears. They had ear for the music. Unko acha lagta tha music, and they had certain ways of playing it at certain spheres or angles in which they could do it. And the other thing that they really liked was, other than music, was maps. We have seen it. Kana unke kabhi they are triangulars or cones or parallelograms or whatever they are, but they are all, everything is done at an angle. And everything was, he said, the houses were so badly built because they was without any right angle, and they were very clumsy. They were in their eyes, they were very mathematical, but they are actually very bad in reasoning and imagination, and everything was strange to them. And something also interesting, that they were afraid that this island is going to be taken over by the sun or the moon or the stars, or it's going to finish. So they were scared that it will be finished. It will finish. Yani dar roz laga rehta tha unko, and every day they lived in fear. And we are also told something about their clothes, that their clothes had moon and the stars and the sun on them, and again, which shows that they were very much into maps or astronomy, you can say, into looking at the things and how things work. And the last thing which we learn about the people, especially the women in this chapter, is that the women, they were not interested in their own husbands which were on the island, because they were too busy with the science and maths and everything that was going on, and they were too afraid to do anything. So when people came from the other islands, there were other islands which belonged to this kingdom, to the king, they came, they visited this island, the women showed more interest in those men, and they had more affection towards them rather than their own people, because those men on the island had no connection with them or no feelings for them whatsoever. Now again, when I look at how women are perceived, again it's a satire upon not only the men or the working of how the kingdom is, or about how the people are, about how they learn about these things. It is, they think so much, it is a satire upon the people who think so much about themselves, and so they are so busy in their what they are doing that they hardly pay any attention to what the other person is saying. They're not willing to learn. And the women in particular, they are more interested in other people. And again, it shows the way Swift saw women, and it's not very pleasantly the way he sees them. As we have learnt about the people who live on the island, we are also going to have a look at the island itself, what kind of place it was, kaisa tha, rocky tha, mountains the, isme kya tha. So we're going to have a look. It was actually circular, it was round in its diameter was about 4 miles, 4.5 miles, 4.5 mi tha. The bottom of the island consisted of one regular plate, so it was one plate at the bottom. Above it lay several minerals, one on top of each other, and it was 12 feet deep. So it was like 1, 2, 3, 4 layers, but it was 12 feet deep. At the center of an island, there was hollow, ek hole tha beech mein, and in that hole they had a depth, and in that depth there were 20 lamps. Iske beech mein there was a it's a circular thing, and inside there was a circular, there's a hole inside the hole, there were circular lamps burning, and also there was a land stone, a big stone kept in the middle of that hole, and that was the one which balanced the island. Island kyunki float, it was floating up there. So if you have something floating up there and you need to balance it, so there has to be something in the middle of the island which helps it to float. Otherwise, if it doesn't float, it will fall. So they had to move that little bit of stone to make it move from here to there. Now it was also moved. The king was in a position to move the island with the help of these people, but there was a certain angle at which it could rise and fall, and it had its limitations, and it could not go above the height, rise above the height of 4 miles. The 4 miles is the maximum that it would go up from the ground where the other islands were. Now astronomy was, as I have mentioned, that astronomy, mathematics, music, astronomy is another thing that they were very, very interested in. And there were certain astronomers and which declared to the king that there were heavenly bodies coming from here and there, and they were able to make certain discoveries about what was around it. And they told him about what was happening, and they had discovered many of the other satellites revolving around other stars as well. Now, the other interesting thing about the islands was that there were other little islands underneath Laputa. This hanging one at the top, and then there were islands at the hanging, not hanging, placed underneath. So these were the ones, they were, now interestingly, the king wanted, if he wanted to punish someone, he took his, the minister's houses were given on the bottom of the island. Now they were done for a purpose so that he could keep them in their, under his control. And if he found ke koi inme se jo hai wo tang kar raha hai, or somebody wanted to rebel against him, he took his island or moved his island on top of the place where the other ministers were living, and then he would actually cover so that there was no rain, no sunshine, no nothing, and they would be in a constant fear of dying. So they would just listen to what the king would do. So ye ek tarika hai to have a force, by force you can say, or by his own will, he wanted to control the people. Now, as we go along, or as we move along, we come to know that these two islands which are described are portray the islands of England, which is on one side, and Ireland, which is very next to it, and it shows that how the changing the stones, moving the island was something which was doing to crush the people on that island. So that's what England was portrayed as doing as well, that wanted to first control Ireland, then get away from it, or control the ministers, or what was going on, or it is again a survey upon the life of the politicians in both of these islands, or how things were going on. Now, the historical basis of rebellion, which is, we are also told, that in Ireland, a successful to the island of William Wood was one of the, he paid one of the ladies, and he actually from furthings of Ireland in it was between Ireland and England actually, that he paid one of the women to go against the king and to circulate all these, and the protest coming up. So all these things also go back to where history lies. So जो भी लिटिल बिट ऑफ थ्रेड्स आर देयर अबाउट व्हाट इज गोइंग ऑन दीज आइलैंड्स फाइंड्स इट्स ट्रेसेस बैक टू हिस्ट्री. इट्स लिंक्ड इन वन वे और द अदर. इट्स इट्स लिंक्ड. एंड वी आर ऑल्सो टोल्ड इन दिस चैप्टर दैट देयर वॉज अ लॉ व्हिच सेड दैट द किंग द क्वीन and two of his sons were not allowed to leave Laputa, the island. That was because the king could only, because in 1701 there was an act of settlement in 1701 in England in which English king could only leave the country when parliament allowed it, otherwise he was not allowed to leave the country. So again, what is happening in Laputa is in connection with what was happening in the history of England in the real sense. And that is a little bit about the land on which he landed and a few other things. Now, in the next chapter, which is chapter 4, we will move about to the other island, Brobdingnag. And because it was Gulliver who wanted to move, he felt a bit neglected there, and he felt a bit strange over there. 2 months he spent there. 2 months he was there, and the flappings and the tradesmen, and he was a bit not happy with that. Now, he was allowed to leave on the recommendation of a lord Munodi. Munodi was a lord who found music, astronomy, maths boring, as Gulliver did. And Gulliver could not hold a good conversation with any of these people because they only talk about maths ki baat karte the, astronomy ki baat karte the, music ki baat karte the. They talked about nothing else. And they didn't want to know anything from him. They didn't want to learn anything from him. So he got a bit bored. Now this person, Munodi, was the one who actually, like Gulliver, wanted to talk about different things, so they became very close. And he gave him a letter of recommendation to his friend in Lagado, which was the metropolis, the capital city. And then he was allowed to leave for Lagado. Lagado was another place which was there, so he was allowed to leave for the Gado, and then he was after staying for the island. He came to live with this Munodi, and he gave him a lot of information about this place, Ballinbarby. So Ballinbarby, he learned that among other things, there were about 40 years who had gone up to Laputa for business, and they had stayed there for a few months, and when they came back, they had disliked what was going on in Laputa. So they started to introduce certain things which were to do with science and mechanics. They had also established an academy there. They had also established many things in that place, Ballinbarby, where they wanted to have a lot of different things from Laputa. So, jab ye yahan rehne ke liye gaya, to he found out that the lord who was there, who was interested like Gulliver, it was quite different from Laputa, because people were more into learning. They wanted more to do with what was going on in the world rather than just there. And Munodi also pointed out that none of the projects people were looking into were not complete, because according to what they were doing, people did not have enough. So he needed some time for them to finish it off, and everything needed to be done. Now, when Gulliver looks at Lagado, he tells us about a continent of बैलन बार्बी ही टेल्स अस कि वो बैलन बार्बी जो है वो कैसा था. द पीपल वॉक फास्ट, दे हैड देयर आईज फिक्स्ड एंड दे वर दे डिडंट हैव मेनी गुड क्लोथ्स ऑन. And then there was no grass, there were no crops growing, the houses were not very repaired, and people didn't look so happy. So again, we are told that this is this land refers to Wales. This was referred to England. And England and the little island was the island, and then this one is about the Welsh people, how the Welsh people looked, and still up to now it's not as rich as England is. They were different, they wanted things to be done differently, they wanted to learn, they wanted to bring in new things, lekin still they lack behind because they were not given enough funds. So again, going back to history, that area is still not as flourished as the king's area, and that sadly still remains as it is. Well, it's not that bad, but it still remains as it is. But it refers to something which is very interesting, which is mentioned that there was a great lord at court nearly related to the king, and for that reason alone was respected. He was universally reckoned as the most ignorant and stupid person among them. He had so ill an ear for music that the detractors reported he had been often known to beat time in the wrong place. So this is, we are told how badly they were ruled by kings who were incompetent kings ki hum baat jo hai wo kar rahe hain. So this was another interesting thing that we are told about Balanbarbi, and we are also told that new agriculture methods were introduced which were going to be brought in, but again that needed to be looked into. There was not enough time and there was not enough spent on it so that the people could be happily living there. Now, as we move along to the next chapter, which is chapter 5, we learn a little bit more about this place and we learn how things are being done there. Now, he visits, he is taken to, Gulliver is taken to visit the Academy of Projections, where he was, different things are going on. One of the projects that is going on is to extract sunbeams from cucumbers. The cucumbers. Now, why would somebody want to extract sunbeams from cucumbers is not to be heard of or not to be seen. Lekin pagal the na, bhai kuch karna hai unhone. So that's what they used to do. So that was something that he saw. और वो क्या करते थे कि they used to take air out, और वो air को पकड़ के they put it into an animal or a human being, killed several animals like that, experimented on them, और air अंदर घुसा के जी बाहर पे निकालेंगे. How the air is used by humans or by living creatures was again something which he found, Gulliver found very strange, but that was going on. And then there was another strange project going on, ke the human poo to be changed into a food. Oh my God, how can it be turned back into food again is beyond again my imagination, but it was silly, it was yuck, but that's what they did over there. And it was horrible. Another method that they were newly forming was a method for building houses. और वो क्या करते थे? The projectors were, they were using ice, turning ice to gunpowder. Well, how can you turn ice to gunpowder? Again, something that only they could understand, but then again, they thought of themselves to be very, very highly scientific people, but that's what they were doing. And then they were also, the most interesting architects they had was a new method of making a house was, again, if you remember, ke wo log kya karte the, they used to put them upside down इन द ग्रेव्स उनको उल्टा दबा देते हैं, ये भी घर ऊपर से शुरू कर लेते, मेकिंग द रूफ फर्स्ट एंड देन कमिंग डाउन. नाउ हाउ ऑन अर्थ विल दे डू दैट, एंड ऑल्सो एक्सपेरिमेंट और के अ ब्लाइंड मैन शुड बी कलरिंग बाई यूजिंग हिज सेंसेस ऑफ स्मेल एंड हिज टच rather than his eyes. So again, something that they just thought of new things to do and new methods of making there. Also a new method of obtaining silk and agriculture devices. Now how would they make silk? From the spider webs. They will just take the spider webs and then looking for something to make silk out of it. How? We don't know, but that was another project going on. Also, a project carried out by a doctor was also performing operations on a pair of on people, on a dog again, and it as I mentioned before, to gather some wind and to pass it through the bodies, and this was done by the doctor, and he just didn't pass through with that project with the dog because the dog passed away. But he thought it was a very good project, so he continued doing that. There was also another experiment which was kind of going on, and that was a universal artist. They called it an artist project, in which they had 50 men working with this artist, and some of them were taking some a tangible substance, and they were just trying to breed sheep from that substance, life bana lo substance se iski life banao, and to make sheep jinke upar koi wool na ho, without they just their bodies, no need for wool because they didn't want wool from the sheep. Why would they do that? Again, we don't know. One thing they also did good was, which I thought was, they produced books. And in philosophy, in poetry, in politics, in law, in maths, and in theology even. The professors who were producing books, but the interesting thing was, these people who were producing books thought that ye lambe lambe words and languages is a waste of time. Let's get rid of the language. Just use two syllables to describe a whole sentence. Yani pure sentence ko bolne ke liye, we just use two words. I haven't got a clue who would do that and how we would do that, but that's what they do. And it's also, ye professors ne ye bhi kaha ke there is not even a need for words even. You can just carry things, pick up a few things and use your bodies or use the things to tell other people what you mean. And then Gulliver just mentioned that ke aapko to bahut sari cheeze carry karni padegi because people won't understand what you are trying to say, but they just had no notion of what was going on, and they just